Now we are in the end of the lesson, so we have finished the limitations and all. Now we'll move to biofuel. What is biofuel? Biofuel is nothing but the algal fuel. The other name is algal fuel, alga. It is the algal biofuel or the algal oil. It is an alternative liquid to the liquid fossil fuels and the petroleum products. Alternative oil for the liquid petroleum and then also for the liquid fossil fuels. And this is the source of energy rich oils. And this algal is an alternative to the common biofuel sources. It is an alternative and it is for the source of the energy rich oils. It is obtained from the corn and sugar cane. It is obtained from corn and sugar cane. The energy crisis, the want for the oil, they have initiated the use for the algal culture, algal fuel oil. This has initiated the algal culture. It is also called as farming alga. Algal culture is also called as farming alga. For making the biodiesel and also the biofuels, the land that is unsuitable for agriculture, for making the land unsuitable for the agricultures, and the land that is unsuited for the agricultures, this type of biofuels are used. Botryococcus Bruni. Botryococcus Bruni is used as the algal biofuel. Algal biofuel is nothing but the algas are used in the production of oil. They are supplementary. They are the used as an alternative for the fossil fuels or the petroleum products, and they are also got from the corn and the sugar cane. The main organism that is used is Botryococcus Bruni, Bruni, Bruni. Next is hydrogen production by alga. In photosynthesis, oxygen is evolved out by the green plants and the green organism. Alga is an autotrophic organism. It will prepare its own food and it will evolve oxygen. That is the normal process. So what happens? The biological hydrogen production with the alga is a method of the photobiological water splitting. So in normal photosynthesis, the alga, Chlamydomonas is the alga, it will release oxygen. When in that medium, when the sulfur, it is deprived, the sulfur is taken out, it switches to the production of hydrogen during the photosynthesis, and the electrons are transmuted to ferredoxygen. So in normal process, oxygen is evolved out. When the sulfur is deprived, sulfur is taken out, so it will release hydrogen, okay, and it is transported to the ferredoxygens, hydrogenase enzymes. This combine into the production of hydrogen gas. Next is bioprospecting. Bioprospecting, it is a process by which the discovery of the commercialization of the new product by the biological process, in which the indigenous knowledge of the nature by the indigenous people is used by the other. So for example, I want to tell you, the neem plant is grown here, and we know the uses of neem and how to use this are olden traditional methods. It is an antiseptic, antibiotic. But this indigenous, we are the indigenous people, and this is used by the foreign countries. They are getting the piracy, they are owning the piracy of that products. For example, the biopiracy of the neem, biopiracy of turmeric, biopiracy of and basmati rice. So what is biopiracy? Defined as the manipulation of the intellectual property rights laws by the corporation to gain the exclusive control over the natural genetic resources without giving adequate recognition to the original process of the resources. Got it? For example, the examples of the biopiracy include the recent patents granted by the US Patent and Trademark Office to America companies on the use of the turmeric, the neem, and most notably the basmati rice also. All three products are indigenous to the Indo-Pakistan subcontinent, but the patent they are got by the US. Biopiracy of neem. The people of the India use neem as oil in many ways for the fungal bacterial infections. Indians have shared the knowledge of the properties of the neem with the worldwide. The United States pirating this knowledge, they have pirated the knowledge of this Indian people, US and then America, United States of Agriculture and then American MNC, W.R. Grace, 90% sort of patent from the European thing, and this method controlling of diseases on the plants, the neem oil, the patenting of the fungicidal and the antibiotic anti-properties of neem was an example of biopiracy, but the traditional methods is protected in the end. So we only know the methods, so it is protected, but the biopiracy is given to other countries. And then the turmeric, and it is another antiseptic which is used in our country for against the bacterial and fungal infections. This is also the patent is got 1955 to the method of use of turmeric as an antiseptic agent. Turmeric has been used by the Indians as a home remedy for a quick healing of the wounds and also for the purpose of rashes. So the journals, articles, Indian Medical Association, they have this remedy was mentioned. Therefore, in this way, it was proved that the use of turmeric is not to the world and it is not a new invention. It is not an invention, but it is an earlier method that is used by the Indians. Similarly, the biopiracy of rice, basmati rice. So September 2, it is patent by the Basmati Rice Lines and Grains to the Texas-based company RiceTech. This broad patent gives the company several rights, including exclusive use of the basmati as well as the proprietary rights on the seeds and the grains from any crosses. The patent also covers the process of breeding RiceTech's novel rice lines and rice grains. So, see, we have got that, but our people have not got any patent right, but the other countries, they have got the patent right. Application of biotechnology is one of the most important applied interdisciplinary science important in the field. Biotechnology is used in the 21st century, in sciences of the 21st century. Biotechnology is wide applications in the field of agriculture, medicines, and we have seen ample examples like golden rice and bioremediation, and then the plastic, avoiding the synthetic plastic, all these things we have seen in the previous classes. And then the development of the transgenics as pesticides, and then the human insulin that is got from the E. coli. These are the uses of biotechnology, and we have also seen the human organisms are used for the medical biomolecular forming, and also the biochip, the genetic engineering methods and single cell proteins, secondary metabolites, all these things are the uses. Though we have got uses, we have got drawbacks also. The more we are going into the science, we are getting the drawbacks. That's about this lesson.